Good morning, students. Today we are back with the part two of Congress rule, and you have already studied about that, how does it happen and what were all of those consequences which were made over there. So anyways, just grab your notebook along with pencil and pen and start noting the important pointers. SLO number 3.1.2, which says that you have to discuss about the impact of the Day of Deliverance. See, when I talk about the Day of Deliverance, then itself it is reflecting about the freedom. So let me just summarize this and tell you, Britishers participated in World War II, and Britishers wanted the Indians to represent as Britishers, or to represent, or you can say that they wanted them to be on the side of Britishers, and they wanted them, the Indians, to participate in World War II from their end, right? So first, in the first half time period, the Congress accepted this decision in replacement of this thing, that the Britishers will hand over the land, properties and everything back after the World War II to the people of India, especially to Indians, right? On this basis, what exactly just happened was that they started to participate in World War II, the Indians started to participate. But later on, when the war was prolonged, then in between the war, Indians said this thing to the Britishers. They wanted a separate identity, and they actually wanted to rule into the subcontinent. So this condition was put by the Indians in front of the Britishers, that we need powers in hand right now. But the Britishers refused them to give the powers, and still they were saying the same thing: according to the commitment which you have made with us, according to that commitment, we are not going to give powers to you right now. We are going to give powers to you later on when World War II will end. But here, about the point of World War II, when we speak about World War II, then nobody knows when it is going to end at that time. So Congress resigned from the ministries, and Congress in between, they left Britishers and they said that we cannot support you into your objective anymore. But as compared to Britishers and Indians, when I talk about Muslims, Muslims supported the Britishers, and Muslims also asked about the freedom, and they also asked about to safeguard their rights. They also asked about a separate identity and for a separate nation. And still, Britishers said that yes, if they will support them, then automatically all of these conditions will be fulfilled and all of these promises will be made and it will be given to you later on. So Muslims safeguard, Muslims actually put the demands forward. Muslims supported the Britishers into this objective. And there, this is how the Britishers promised to safeguard their rights for later purpose as well. So you can see in this slide very clearly that Viceroy refused the demands for the Congress. And then on October 27th, 1939, Congress ministries were resigned. Then Viceroy and Muslim League were pleased. How they were pleased? You can see it over here. Qaid-e-Azam addressing the Muslim League session in 1938, in which Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah declared the Day of Deliverance. The Day of Deliverance means that it is the end of the Congress rule. And then he was giving the thanks, and you can say he was giving the token of thanks and relief to all of those people who were supporting Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah at that time. And thus, it was because it was the end of the Congress rule, which was the eye-opener for all of the Muslims of India, which were living in the subcontinent at that time. And they also realized that they're having an option left for the independence, that finally they can speak about it. So Day of Deliverance, according to Qaid-e-Azam's statement, he said that, "I wish the Muslims all over India to celebrate Friday 2nd, to celebrate 22nd December as the Day of Deliverance." And yes, he was to celebrate 22nd. Okay, now the day of deliverance, you can see it very clearly that how it is written over here. Okay, and yes, this is also marked as a very important point in the history of Pakistan and into the past historical background. You can see it very clearly that why day of deliverance plays a very important role, because it was the end of the Congress rule. And then on December 22nd, 1939, the Muslims observed Day of Deliverance across the country. So the impact of Day of Deliverance in 1939 was that Congress was deeply offended on the Muslims on the celebration of Day of Deliverance. And then consequently, only 3 months later, the demand for the partition of India was formally put forward by the Muslim League. And then the stage was set for the struggle that culminated in the birth of Pakistan. So this is how we actually got Pakistan. But yes, there are other events as well, which are still left over in between the journey of Pakistan. So this is the assignment for today. There are 5 questions which are listed over here, which you have to complete. And then you have to post it under my instructions on KP. Question number 1. What was the impact of Congress rule on the Muslims of the subcontinent? Question number 2, why Congress rule is considered to be an important event in the history of the subcontinent? Question number 3, what was the reaction of Muslims towards Wardha's scheme? Question number 4, why Congress resigned from the ministry? And question number 5, what was the impact of Day of Deliverance 1939? Thank you so much, everyone. I hope that this presentation turned out to be something very important for all of you. And still, if you people are having any sort of questions, so definitely you can ask me in the comments section on KP. Inshallah, we'll return back soon with another presentation for all of you. Till then, take care. Barakallah and Allah Hafiz.